56.4 to go. And no more timeouts for either team. And now all over the arena, they are standing. Same two men for what might be the draw of the year. To either extend the game, or in the case of Pittsburgh, to end it and win a Stanley Cup. Cullen and Fisher. Off the tie-up. And it's left on back down by Subban. Close quarters now is Forsberg. Down back up by Cullen. Pitch back by Forsberg and Arvidsson. Got it around behind the deal. Step to the front. Pick it gets shot away. Loose puck is picked up now by Hornquist and now back out. Along the turn is Subban. 28 seconds to go. Able to move away from Kunitz. Subban able to get it one side back to Arvidsson. Arvidsson trying to play it to the front. Gumelin got there. Horse back off the boards and Subban can't catch up to it. Along comes Hagelin moving on and he scores! Hagelin with 13.6 to go! And the Penguins celebrate at the bench. They almost clocked their coach, Mike Sullivan, with the stray stick. Salary cap era. The owner and rescuer of the franchise, the coaching staff, celebrating the empty net goal by Carl Hagelin. They came up with four disciplined kick bodies, meaning make sure you get a physical piece of the opponent. Compete level and puck management, those were the foundation of the Stanley Cup. On this t-shirt, with all the names of the current players and the support players from Wilkes-Barre Scranton. And they continue to jump up and down at the Penguins bench. And the party that went on inside their arena back home and out where their arena was once located will continue into the night, and they will await yet another parade, the fifth one since 1991. The final seconds go on, and now the fans here salute their team with Let's Go Predators. A turnaround shot that rattled wide. Subban one more try, deflected over the net, and the Pittsburgh Penguins again are the Stanley Cup champions. Let's go, friends.
The Predators wait patiently. The motto here was stand with us, and these people did stand with their team. All games this season, for the first time in the 19-year history, were sold out. And now they wait for the handshake line to form. Usually it is the captains who are at the forefront of this. And eventually it will begin. The first handshakes began in hockey in 1904. That was long before the National Hockey League ever came into existence, and long before they took possession of the Stanley Cup. Part of an old Canadian tradition. And now they peel away from the celebration for congratulations to each other. And leading the way is Brian Dumoulin for the Penguins and P.K. Subban for the Predators. And with all that happened during the course of this, P.K. Subban is coming very close to Sidney Crosby. And so we will watch with interest. Some slaps on the shoulders, and they move on. Chris Letang got into his uniform, not able to play during these playoffs, and not until next fall, but there to join his team. You win, Doc. You have a lot of adversity. The Penguins win without their best defenseman and all the injuries that they had. All teams have injuries over the course of 7-8 weeks. Nick Bonino could barely stand up. He's out there in a celebration. But back-to-back, all the different line combinations for Mike Sullivan this year compared to last year. How about the job by Marc-Andre Fleury in these playoffs? The game 7 against Washington, a shutout after struggling in back-to-back games at 5 and 6. You need everybody. You never know when your number's going to be called. Just an amazing run for the Pittsburgh Penguins. The goaltenders meet. I thought we'd probably still be playing as expertly as these two guys played in this game tonight. And particularly on their home ice. The Conn Smythe Trophy is presented to the player judged to be the most valuable player in the playoffs. Mario Lemieux won it back-to-back here. Sidney Crosby has won it once, and Evgeny Malkin. The Predators salute their fans one last time. The conquest over Chicago. St. Louis. Taking the defending champions to 6. A team to be proud of, for sure. Here is Pierre with Sidney Crosby.
Thank you very much, Scott. Last team to go back-to-back, 97 and 98, Detroit Red Wings. What does this mean to the Pittsburgh Penguins matching up?
Well, it's tough. I mean, you know, we knew it was going to be tough all year, but we just tried to keep with it. We had a lot of injuries and things like that, so just kept finding ways. That was really what we did all season, all playoffs, and it's great to be able to do it.
How did you guys keep it on the rails? You had to kill off a huge 5-on-3 in the third period.
Yeah, that's huge. I mean, Mark Kill did a great job. Murray made some saves, and then I think we got a boost from that. We were able to get some momentum after that, and then Horny gets a big goal there.
Were you able to build off game 5? Is that one of the things that really gave you confidence coming back in here? Because games 3 and 4 did not go well for you.
Yeah, I think even 4, I thought we did some good things. So I think, you know, all playoffs long, we got better each series, you know, went on. So we tried to do that in this series, and I thought we did a good job of that.
Two Olympic gold medals, one World Cup of Hockey, three Stanley Cups. I know you're modest. Let's talk about your legacy. What does this mean to your legacy?
I don't think about that a whole lot. I think just to be able to share this with this group of guys, a good chunk of our return, and it's pretty special, but I mean, for the new guys, just to be able to share that with this group. I mean, that was our goal at the start of the year. We knew it hadn't been done in a long time, and to be able to accomplish it is a great feeling.
Congratulations, Steve.
Thanks.
Very calm. He's 29. His first interview that he ever did was when he was 7. Pretty excited here. On the goal by Carl Hagelin into the empty net, that signaled that the celebration back in Pittsburgh could start, because there was Sherman starting at the bench.
He was flat out awesome in game 4 here, and then that game 5 back in Pittsburgh. First shift of the game.
All right, the presentation of the Conn Smythe Trophy. Here's an announcer from the game. This thing looks pretty great.
Ladies and gentlemen,
shine with brilliance. To mixed reviews, many of the people here wearing the gold of the Predators are staying around because even though they're not happy with who's winning it, it is a marvel to behold.
Year and the 125th year of the Stanley Cup. It's only fitting that a team
tremendous spring for him. Came to the team in February and played his first game against Philadelphia at Heinz Field. And Matt Cullen at age 40, maybe this is it. It is his third Stanley Cup. What a way to go, winning important faceoffs, especially when his team was shorthanded. Chris Kunitz, this is number four, leading all active players. Up and down the lineup. Play with your star players, play with your role players, and give you a little bit of that, physicality and that nasty, Doc. It's been a great pro. Evgeny Malkin finishes with the most points of anybody in these playoffs. And so he now has three. Mark Streit came to the team the latter part of the season as insurance on defense, and he played in these playoff games. The Stanley Cup last year. He was handed it first by Sidney Crosby. She is not with us now, but it was a special moment for her and for her son. Phil Kessel gets it this time. With the four combinations. This year, many, many different line combinations. I wonder how he's going to do with this, because that one foot's not very good. I guess he's okay. That adrenaline is flying, Doc. How many times did we think, well, they're too broken and they're too tired. They can't keep going on. And that was against Washington and against Ottawa, and actually against Nashville, but they persist in winning. Stay tuned on most of these NBC stations for your local news. On the West Coast, it's an all-new Sunday night with Megyn Kelly at 10 p.m. Pacific. And right now, over on NBCSN, the Penguins Stanley Cup celebration continues live from Nashville. For Eddie Olczyk and Pierre Maguire, I'm Mike Emmer. By the way, training camps open on or around September 14th.
From inside PPG Pants Arena tonight to Patrick Hornquist's game-winning goal. The Penguins are now back-to-back Stanley Cup champions. They're bringing home their fifth cup in franchise history.
That was a sold-out crowd, by the way. You can bet they were super excited. And here's a live look at the south side of Pittsburgh. The fans here just going crazy tonight. You can see them hoisting up This is one of those many makeshift
Stanley
Cup trophies making the rounds right there. So they are super excited. The city of Pittsburgh is going to allow people about 90 minutes or so from the end of the game for the celebrations, and this is going to be continuing on for the next 90 minutes. So sometime around 12:33, give or take a few minutes, that's when the police will be saying clear it out. But for now, this is the time for the city of Pittsburgh to celebrate. You can see these are live pictures showing the celebration right now, giving us a bird's eye view. Fans just pouring out into the street, super excited, and we're going to be going to Marlisa in just a bit. And Catherine, we have a team of reporters covering this from all angles tonight.
East Carson Street is actually shut down. They shut it down earlier tonight from 10th Street to 22nd. They wanted to stop people from flooding into that area should the Pens win, which they obviously have won now. And you see all those fans flooding out into the streets celebrating this huge victory of back-to-back Stanley Cup championship. 11 on the ice, living up to his name.
They did not want to have it to go to a Game 7. I don't think our beating hearts could have taken a Game 7, but you just watched the Penguins win the Cup here on WPXI. And we talked about this. This is the first time back-to-back Stanley Cups in the Salary Cup era. So this is really huge. And the first time in Sid Crosby was a Conn Smythe Award.
Yeah, he's the third player to win back-to-back Conn Smythe. One other person, Mario Lemieux. That was back when the Penguins went back-to-back Cups back in 91 and 92. Right now, we're going to go out live with some of those fans. Can you believe they sold out PPG Paints Arena tonight just so they could watch the game out there? Catherine, it looks like a lot of the crowd is already left, probably out in the streets partying right now.
Unfortunately, I will tell you, that's actually cleared out pretty quickly. Take a look around me here. There are 18,000 plus fans in here at one point. Now there's maybe a couple dozen. So things cleared out pretty quickly as they all moved out into the street. But it was electric inside here. As soon as we got that first goal, this whole place was shaking. I could feel my feet crumbling underneath the floor. People were throwing bottles, makeshift Stanley Cup hats right onto the ice. You can see they're actually working on cleaning the ice right now. But all night tonight, we actually felt like we were actually at the Penguins game in Nashville. It really didn't feel like there was no hockey team on the ice. It was just electric and insane inside this arena. We talked to some few fans right after those two goals were scored. Take a listen to what they had to say about the game. Looks like we don't have those fan reactions right now, but I can tell you everyone was ecstatic in here. I talked to an 11-year-old boy who said he has never seen anything like here, and other people said they weren't so sure what to expect when they came down here today. I was here last year, and it was very much the same scene of when they won the Stanley Cup. Everyone just went wild. They were doing waves across. You can check out my Twitter for some of that video that we have on the WPXI Barnum, and everyone really just, it lived up to its expectations. They had the lights going, they had the sound going, they had, they're shooting up t-shirts during each intermission, so it really made you feel like you were at one of the games. The tickets here were only $10 to get in, so this place...
Bridgestone Arena in Nashville. Nashville Predator fans pouring out into the streets right now. And really, a lot of them stayed through the ceremony there where the Stanley Cup was presented. They also stayed through the Conn Smythe presentation. There was a lot of booing when Sidney Crosby won. Not big fans of him down there right now, but pretty respectful overall, the fact that they wanted to be there and see that moment when the cup was presented. And now we're looking at live pictures here on the south side. The celebrations in the streets out there.
This is very exciting for everyone out there. And we want to tell our viewers out there to keep it right here. We are standing by. We are waiting for live locker room reaction. I know that you want to hear from all of your favorite players as well as Coach Mike Sullivan. It's been a tough road to get here to this point. And we've talked about this. What a grueling schedule it is for the NHL playoff schedule. Now we see Albie Oxenreider. You can see him right there on the ice.
Okay.
Albie, get a reaction.
Gordon and Lisa, we're on the ice right now, and here's Sidney Crosby with the cup. How are you, Sid?
Good, how you doing?
Congratulations.
Thank you, appreciate it. Thanks a lot.
Going to the podium, guys.
Yeah, I'm going to the podium, sorry.
Going to the podium, thanks. Not just any media. Okay. Just tell our cameras how it feels.
That's great. That's unbelievable. We knew it was going to be tough to get back here, so it's
this is what you dream of. You know, you and four of your teammates now have three. Thank you, Sid. All right, Sidney Crosby's being let off the ice. Let's get back to Gordon and Lisa.
All right, Albion, we know you're going to continue to work to get some of the player interviews. I'm taking Sidney right now to the podium where he can do interviews with all the media. But as you can see, Albie, able to get in there before anybody else.
I was standing here again.
The resiliency of this team has been remarkable. The injuries we talked about are all season long. But to come out on top, what does that feel like?
No, obviously, we know we have a really good core group in our locker room. And with Sid, Gino, Phil, and, you know, Murray and then Flower in the same team, that says a lot. Those five guys are unbelievable leaders on and off the ice. And without them, that's no way we're going to win the second cup.
We're celebrating here in Nashville, but what do you say to the Pittsburgh fans that are watching back at PPG?
No, obviously, thanks a lot for all your support the whole year. And yeah, we're coming home and celebrating with you guys. But thank you.
One of those were.
All right, guys, there it was.
But we still believe, like, at home game five, we still believe we have a great chance to win back to Nashville and win game six.
All right, that was Evgeny Malkin right there doing some interviews for us, and right now we're going to send it